When do you start?
I'm rolling right now.
Yeah, oh so. My God.
They'll cut it. They'll cut
Let it. Hi, I'm Dr. Anuradha Singh. I'm one of the adult epilepsy specialists at Icahn School of Medicine.
And I'm Dr. Panov, and I'm one of the neurosurgeons at Mount Sinai.
I'm Dr. Natasha Acosta Diaz. I'm one of the pediatric epileptologists.
Is epilepsy contagious?
No, really good no. One. Epilepsy is not contagious. You cannot spread epilepsy from one person to the other. It's not an infection. It's a neurological condition that is characterized by having seizures, and it's caused by an abnormal brain electrical activity. But there's no way that you're gonna get epilepsy just because of being with somebody that has the condition.
I think an incredibly damaging myth, because in the past there have been significant events where people were burned at the stake because they were considered epileptics and the community did not want it spread. So yes, please debunk this one. It is not contagious. Go for it.
Let's see. Is epilepsy EEG testing painful?
I don't think so. No, no. So standard EEG that we do, it's like a 20 minutes to 1 hour test, and it's not painful. The electrodes do not go deep in the brain. They're just outside on the scalp. And no, it's not painful at all.
Now, what is EEG testing?
So EEG is a testing where you study brain rhythms, electrical rhythms of the brain, and it's not a painful test at all. You know, the electrodes are put on the scalp. They don't go deep in the brain. And usually a standard EEG is about 20 minutes to about 60 minutes test. Sometimes you get a little glue left in your scalp, but it's not painful at all.
You just have to wash your hair after.
That's great.
Yes.
Okay, we'll go to you for the next reveal.
Sure. Is epilepsy surgery dangerous? Ted, you want to take this question?
Sure. So the myths about the danger of epilepsy surgery really again come from the past, from about the last 100 years or so. And what you currently find on the internet, unfortunately, is not appropriate, and it just perpetuates this myth that epilepsy surgery is dangerous. Epilepsy surgery has its risks and its benefits, but most certainly the benefits outweigh the risks. And if we compare it to the dangers that we go through in regular life, and especially the dangers that the epilepsy patients undergo, the way we phrase it to our patients is a year with epilepsy by far outweighs any risks of surgical intervention to try to cure the epilepsy itself. Next one, can seizures be triggered by flashing lights? Who'd like to take this one?
There's some type of epilepsy that can be triggered by flashing lights. However, this is very rare, it's not something common. And when we're testing a patient for epilepsy, we do flashing lights to see if we can provoke a seizure, and then we can give some recommendations. This is called photosensitive epilepsy.
And so for the next one,
let's see.
Natasha, you hold. Can people with epilepsy drive a car?
Yes, you can drive a car if you're seizure-free for several months or so, but you have to check with the DMV, the Department of Motor Vehicles, that what are the rules and regulations by state. They may require some additional documentation from the doctor, some results of your test like EEG, MRI, CAT scan reports, etc., etc. So you have to check with your state.
The next question is, can people with epilepsy have a job? Absolutely. You know, it's a myth to say that you cannot work if you have seizures. Now, of course, just overall, you have to discuss it with your healthcare provider. You need to make sure that this job is right for you. But the whole point of our team here is to get you back to the world, to be able to interact in the world. And if there's a job that you love, to get you back to that job.
There is American Disability Act, which just makes it illegal to fire somebody who has epilepsy.
So guys, do you think that patients have to disclose to their employees or really to anyone that they have epilepsy?
It's not mandatory, but I always recommend that you tell somebody that you have epilepsy. Just in case you have a seizure, somebody can be with you or can help you. What do you think?
Yeah, you don't have to disclose your medical condition unless the doctor in some states feel that the particular job that they are doing is dangerous.
We'll move on to the next one. We'll flip it all the way around. And for the next one we have,
do it.
Can people with epilepsy have children?
Yes, people with epilepsy, women with epilepsy can have normal, happy, healthy children. That's happening almost every day. But you have to work in collaboration with your OB doctors and your epilepsy specialist to make sure that you're on the safest drugs used for epilepsy. And whenever you get pregnant, after your husband knows that you're pregnant, the next person who should know that you're pregnant is should be your epilepsy specialist.
Let us know if you're planning to get pregnant so we can work together having a healthy baby. I'm gonna give it to you.
Yeah, that's right.
I don't have my glasses, so I'm gonna read it.
Children. All right, the next one is, can people with epilepsy stop taking their medications?
Ted, what do you think after surgeries? Do you stop medications or do you send them to us for further?
So we definitely sent them to an appropriate healthcare professional, which are our wonderful and amazing epileptologists. But the whole goal of the Comprehensive Epilepsy Center is to get our patients seizure-free and to get them off the medications. Yes, the idea is that you will come off your meds once the seizures stop.
Please do not stop taking your medication before discussing with us. There's a way of doing, there's a specific time when we're ready to do that. So please take your medication, never stop.
And a lot of thoughts go into that who can come off the medication. It depends on what your MRI of the brain shows. It depends on what your EEG results are. So it should be done very cautiously and with the consultation with an epilepsy specialist.
All right, good. Next one. Ready. I'll hold the next one. You do the honors.
Let's see.
Because I've been very bad at unsticking them.
Can people with epilepsy swallow their tongue? What do you think,
no
Natasha?
Way, no way. There's no way that you're gonna swallow your tongue. Sometimes you're having a big seizure and there's a lot of shaking and jerking and the tongue can go to the side and people can bite the tongue. What I always tell the patients, you know, stay with them, be calm, make sure you're putting the patient to the side. Don't put anything on the mouth. Please do not put anything on the mouth when a patient is having a seizure.
We are almost done. This is the last one.
Let's do it.
Great work so far. Let's not mess the last one up. Ready? Okay. Does a keto diet help people with epilepsy?
It does. In certain cases, it does. So ketogenic diet, those who are not familiar with this diet, is a certain proportion of fats, certain proportion of proteins and carbohydrates. So very classic ketogenic diets, they allow 4 portions of fat and 1 portion of carbohydrates, usually about, I would say, 5 to 10% of carbohydrates, 10 to 20% of the proteins and about 70 to 80% of the fats. I know Natasha is a Peds epileptologist, so you use it much way more in pediatric epilepsy. Hundreds
yes,
of seizures
it's
a
interesting.
Day.
Since like 1920s, the ketogenic diet has been used in some cases of patients with epilepsy and some cases that medication are not working. But it's like, as you were explaining, there's a specific ratio. It's not so easy. You need a good team to be able to get a patient into the ketosis. And we do know that that has anticonvulsant effects, you know, the whole metabolic change. But you need a good nutritional, you need to be in a good hospital. So it's not something that you can try by yourself at home. It's not just doing a diet, a keto diet to lose weight and let me control my seizures, you know? It has to be done with a healthcare provider. But definitely works.
Thank you so much. We hope that this was informative, and please reach out to us in the comments regarding any other questions you would have about epilepsy.
Please do it, throw it, like I always
we
throw
it. Okay. Like every single day for
I'm worried I'm going to hurt someone.
Do it. Yay!
Yeah.
Good, yeah!